Hello friends, this is Kostas and welcome to my channel. I'm from Athens, Greece. I hope I will not destroy your ears with my English pronunciation. Usually I make short films with drones, but now we are in lockdown here in Athens too. So I decided to make a small series about the equipment I use in my home office. And this is the first episode, the monitor. So let's proceed. Let's go with the unboxing. The package is around 14.5 kilos. So let's unbox it. Boring. Let's speed it up a little. A plastic bag with cables and stuff. Let's see what's inside. A huge power supply, 210 watts. The power cord. A metal plate for installation. I think I will not need it. A power cord extension. The USB-C cable. The HDMI cable. Paperwork, installations and stuff. A sticker and a CD-ROM with drivers. Wow, who uses CD-ROM these days? So, that's all inside the bag. Let's see what's next. The monitor's ergonomic arm. This is the monitor's base, there isn't another one. It says that first we have to install it and then to remove the upper packaging. And this is the monitor. With a white back. There is a similar model with a black back. More in the description below. See how anti-glare is the screen. You cannot see neither the lights or my tripod. Now it's time to install it. Well, I don't have a spare room at my home to use it as an office, so I had to be very creative and as minimalist as possible. That's why I chose this small available space to use it as an office and on this long and narrow IKEA furniture. This ergonomic monitor will be ideal since it doesn't take up any space. So let's start with the placement of the arm. It is very easy. We just need to place the arm on the edge of the furniture and fasten it by tightening its special base on the furniture. Now it's time for the sticker. The sticker protects the wall from scratches. After placing the arm, we remove the upper packaging. Now it's time to place the screen. It's very easy. Just with one click. So, let's proceed with the cables. I will connect the monitor with three devices. My MacBook Pro, my Mac Mini M1 and my iPad Pro 2020. So, I have to install three cables. This is the power cord extension. This cable extends the distance between the monitor and the power supply. At the monitor's middle arm, there is a hole, so we have to pass the cables through that hole, and then we will place them inside the big arm. This is the USB-C cable. The USB-C port is a power delivery port with 60 watts. You can use it not only as a display, but to charge your notebook or your iPad or as a USB hub. Now let's place the two HDMI cables. The monitor has also a headphones jack, a USB 3 hub with two USB 3 ports and a display port of version 1.4. Now we place the cables carefully in the groove of the big arm and cover the groove with a special cover. Then we put the lid on and we are ready. As I mentioned earlier, I use this monitor to connect three devices, a MacBook Pro, a Mac Mini M1 and an iPad Pro 2020. So let's find out about the monitor settings and which of them I use for connecting the devices I mentioned. The monitor's menu is accessible through a small joystick below the LG label. If you press it, you have four selections: input, picture mode, settings and power off. From the input, you select which input signal you will display. From the settings, you have access to all the settings of the monitor. And from the picture mode, you select just the picture mode of the monitor. The monitor has a lot of picture modes, but for the connection with the Apple devices, I use the DCI P3. Also, there is the sRGB picture mode, which is suitable for editing photos for printing. So when you select the DCI P3 picture mode, you can adjust only the brightness. Everything else is predefined by the manufacturer. From the general settings, you have to turn off the smart energy saving in order the monitor not to alternate the brightness. Also, when you connect the monitor through HDMI, you can turn on the deep color for better color reproduction. At the computer's display settings, you have to be sure that the high dynamic range is off. Also, you have to turn off the night shift mode for better color accuracy. Because the fonts are very small in the native resolution, I choose the 1080 display like. In that resolution, you double the scale of the fonts and the interface, but the real resolution of the video and the image remained at 4K. So, if you are working in a video editing program like me, for instance the DaVinci Resolve, and want to have more space for your image, you can turn the resolution to 4K. If you want to have more space for the interface, you can turn the monitor's resolution to 1080. Also, be aware in the iPad to go to display settings and in the connected displays, you have to turn off the high dynamic range for better color accuracy. I deal a lot with video editing and I have been looking for a suitable monitor for a long time. The monitor had to be at least 4K and as color accurate as possible. So it had to comply with the new DCI P3 color space, which has been created for the digital movie projection from the American film industry. DCI P3 can display more colors than the sRGB and the REC 709. The last 5 years, all the big manufacturers like Samsung, Apple or Google started to support the DCI P3 color in their products. Also, the monitor had to be a 10-bit monitor, since all my cameras produce 10-bit footage. In my search, I did not find many monitors with these characteristics. The majority of them are very expensive, at least 2 or 3,000 euros. The cheapest was around 1,300. And then this monitor. It's an IPS monitor of 32 inches with 4K resolution and 10-bit color. It complies at 95% with DCI-P3 color space. This means 100% comply with the REC709 and sRGB. It can support 4 different input sources, 2 HDMI, 1 USB-C and 1 DisplayPort. And also, it's extremely versatile in ergonomics, ideal for my home office since I don't have much space at home. And all of this just for 750 euros. In the description below, you can find more details about this monitor. If you like my review, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much for watching. Have a nice time.